because they have lived in a different world, different set of circumstances, which we cannot even recreate. And the learnings they have from that are invaluable. Okay? So, and again, I'm not the only one saying that. You know, there are other people who have put, you know, quotations. Good judgment comes from experience, and experience comes from bad judgment. So, would you rather make bad judgment and get experience yourself? Or would you rather take somebody else's experience and move on? You make your choice. You are, of course, welcome to make bad judgment, suffer through the consequences, and then learn from that, of course. You're welcome to do that. But if you are really smart, you will do the thing on the left side. And the other statement is also, you know, caution for the people who are experienced. Sometimes, you know, we tend to think that, hey, I've been doing this for the last 20 years, so don't tell me to change. That's not really true either. Because the world is changing, so we have to change. But experience still is very, very important. And the only way you get experience is through time. So it's not like, you know, well, I'm going to go to this university and I'm going to suddenly get 10 years experience. Can't do that. It takes 10 years to get 10 years experience. Okay? So it's one of those things that there are no shortcuts. I mentioned stress earlier. I think leading a balanced life is very, very important. And balance is, you know, of a variety of things. There is a lot more talk these days about work-life balance. There are many conflicts that one faces as you go through your career, go through your life, seemingly contradictory things. We have to make choices. So this balancing has to do with what is your perspective on life? What factors do you consider when you make choices? And this idea of, are you making shortcuts? For example, is cost more important or quality more important? Is time, you know, schedule to meet, complete something more important, or how well you do it more important? Okay? And nobody will see, so it's okay, you know, we can do it this way. And that is how a lot of problems are created. And these days, in the electronic age, you know, text messages, emails that people have sent, seemingly thinking that, oh, nobody will know because I'm just doing it on my laptop or on my iPhone, you know, those have come back to, you know, sync them, right? So when we take shortcuts, the joy of that shortcut is actually short-lived because the consequence of that, you know, can be enormous. So in addition to working hard and working smartly, be 100% ethical. Okay? There is no shortcut for being ethical. You must be ethical. That is not an option. It's something that you must do. At the same time, don't forget about your family. Don't forget about your own health. And then cultivate interest beyond your profession. Volunteer somewhere. You know, go help other people. You know, if you are an engineer, do something else. Learn about the arts. They will all help you. Actually, I learned most of my project management not at work. I learned most of my project management by being a volunteer somewhere. It was fun because I'm running somebody else's project. If I make a mistake, it's their project. It's not even my project. Right? And there are people who will help you because in a volunteer organization, just like you, there are other people. And if you don't know, you can go and ask them. I can go to my boss and say, boss, I don't know how to do this, so can you tell me? He'll say, hey, who made you the project manager? But in a volunteer organization, you can ask. Right? So do other things. Don't just do only your work. Because if you do only your work, the chances are you will need that get well chair, which you don't want. Okay, get well chair is good to sit in the hospital or sit there, but you don't want to be sitting on it. Okay, so balancing all these things, your physical, which is the taking care of your health, mental health is equally important. Think about the people, the social activities. Spiritual is also very important. Think a little bit beyond what you can see. There are a lot of things that you can't see, but you still need. And then the emotional part of it, which I mentioned earlier as the emotional quotient. So it's really, life is about a combination of these things. Even if we are technologists and we like technology and we love technology, all that is great, but life is more than technology. You know, there's a statement that I've heard, you know, when people are dying, nobody says, I wish I had done more technology and solved that equation. Okay? They always say, I wish I had spent more time with my son. I wish I had spent more time with my dog. I wish I had, you know, been nicer to people. That's what they always say. Nobody say, I think I should have solved that problem, you know. What is this? I'm dying already and that problem remains unsolved. Nobody says that. Right? So develop some other things. And I know people who retire and say, I'm retired, but I don't know what to do. What do you mean you don't know what to do? I spent all my life with this job. I don't know what to do now. I want to go back to the job. But the job people say, hey, you know, we don't want you here. That chair is already given to somebody else. No, but can I please sit in this corner because I like this office? I mean, do something, develop some other interest. Go help other people. You know, read, exercise, jog, do something, okay? But you cannot do that when you are 60 years old. That's the point. You cannot suddenly say, well, tomorrow I'm going to be 60 years old, so I'm going to transform my life. I'm going to develop this new hobby. It doesn't work. You have to develop those from day one. So you got to do that. Change. This is another thing that comes up all the time. We are all, as a general rule, deathly afraid of change. Oh my God, I can't change. You know, this is very, very important. This is what I have been doing all my life. I can't give this up. Okay? But the world is changing. Whether you like it or not, the world is becoming flat, becoming curved, becoming, you know, potato chip-like, whatever it is. But the world is changing. So if you insist, no, I'm going to be the way I always was because that is the way I have been for the last, you know, X number of years, then you will become obsolete. People will say, you know, nice knowing you, bye-bye. Okay? So you have to change. Don't be afraid of it. I say embrace it because, hey, if you embrace it, it's too close to you. It can't do too much. Have you seen boxing matches? Recently, Olympics. When they're getting beat, what do they do? Oh. Right? You can't hit me now because I'm too close to you. Oh, no, you can't do that. So accept the change. Embrace it. And the other thing that I have noticed is if you are willing to change, then there are opportunities. Because all the normal things people are already doing. So why do they need you? It's already, you know, being taken care of by someone else. So we don't need you. You're just an intruder. You know, stay away. But new things, nobody wants to do those. It's something different. So if you come along and say, I can help, I can contribute, then yeah, you're welcome. Well, you know how to do something. Come. Okay? Every job I have had is not because I was experienced in doing that, because I was the crazy guy who said, yes, I want to do that. Every assignment that I've had. Okay? So you don't have to be an expert. But you must know something. You must be willing to go and work hard. You must be willing to learn. You don't have to be the expert. You must know how to work with the experts. Okay? But you must be willing to change and adapt yourself. The way we work in the US is very different from the way I have to work here. The way you work in a university is very different from the way you work in industry. Okay? So you cannot say, this is the way I am going to be. Okay? You can be that way. Everybody else will be some other way. Okay? So if you want to fit in, you want to contribute, you have to be willing to change. I think we're almost coming to the end here. Courage is very important. You know, this thing said it was leadership series, so I figure I must tell you something about it. Leaders have to be courageous. On the one hand, you have to take the rest of the team along with you, but at the same time, sometimes you have to make difficult decisions. Sometimes they are unpopular decisions. And you must have the courage to say, no, this is what we should do, for good reasons, of course. And also, you need the courage to admit mistakes, because people do make mistakes. And it is better for you to admit the mistake yourself than other people telling you you made a mistake. So courage is very important. But there are some fundamental principles that you must You must know what those fundamental principles are. There are plenty of books out there that you can learn from, but stay true to those principles. Okay, this is the last chart. So there are three quotes I'm going to show you, which in some sense are very important in the way they have shaped my life. First one is from a spiritual teacher, but it is not about spirituality, it's really about life. If you want to be happy, don't give the key to that happiness to somebody else. And what it basically means is you are in charge, or take responsibility for your happiness yourself. Don't say, I'm this way because my mommy was treated me this, you know, differently when I was 4 or 5 years old, or I'm this way because, you know, I went to so-and-so university, or I came from so-and-so town. Those things don't matter. You are who you are because of you. You have nobody else to blame. Okay? Take responsibility for whatever your happiness and success needs to be. Now, we all talk about this, you know, famous race. But the important thing is, if you win the rat race, what do you get? You're another rat. Do you want to be a rat? How many of us want to be rats? I don't want to be a rat. Then the next question is, what do you want to be? Well, not a rat. I want to be something else. So you want to be something else other than a rat, don't get caught up in the rat race. Because if you get caught up in the rat race, you get, you get stressed out and you have to use that special chair. Okay? So the idea here is, don't be a copycat like everybody else. Don't go to join the IT industry because everybody else is joining IT industry. Okay? Don't do aerospace program because everybody else is doing aerospace program. Do something different. If you do something different, then you are unique. If you are unique, people will look up and say, hey, this guy is different. Okay? If you are like 100 other people, okay. You are like 100 other people. You don't have that much value. You want to make a mark, you want to be different. Don't be like everybody else. This one is interesting. Stephen Covey, do you know who Stephen Covey was? The Seven Habits, right? He passed away recently, and this is a quote, one of his quotes. I mean, there were several quotes of his, of course, and something that appealed to me. I can't say that I follow this because I'm not sure what these things are he's talking about. But the main thing that he's talking about is the main thing in the middle. Okay? Keep the main thing the main thing. What is the main thing? It is your idea of success. It's your idea of happiness. So be clear about what that is. Come back to the very first point I was trying to make. Be clear about that, because if you keep that in focus, keep those fundamental principles in focus, everything else will fall into place. The confusion comes to our minds because we don't know what success means. We don't know what we want. Okay? If you don't know what you're going, you will never know when you got there. Right? If I know I have to go from here to the airport, when I get to the airport, I'll know, okay, I reached my destination. But suppose I tell my driver, go in that direction. How far should I go? Just go. How long should I go until I run out of gas? Right? So, in order to know that I reached there or I'm getting closer to my destination, I must know what the main thing is and keep that in focus.